I've come today to talk about our home, which is something that we've been, my wife and I, Lori, who's here today as well, been thinking about manifesting a new home. We've been in this house for about 14 years now, since the birth of my first son, and there's been an awful lot of transition and change during those years, obviously. We've grown a lot, and the issue with the house is that it's paid for. The current condition is pretty run down. The roof is ready to be replaced. Foundation is cracked in many places, but it's in a wonderful area. We have a half acre of land. We bought the house because we love the neighborhood and the thought of, at some point building up the house or adding on to it was something we always had. But after we moved in, we ran into a lot of problems with the home. First spring, when it rained, we found out that the basement wasn't watertight. And so even though it was all fixed up in the basement, we had to tear everything out. And from that point on, it's been kind of this struggle about what are we going to do? Are we going to wait till we have the funds to tear it down and rebuild new? Are we going to fix it up and move on? But all along the way, we've been getting a lot more information to sift through, and we keep getting bigger and bigger dreams. The kids like the schools that they're in. They don't really want to move somewhere else out of the school district. Just to add on to, the growing thoughts, we're believing we could have what we want. And, just the other day, Lori and I went out and we went on this luxury home tour in the area, and that really gave us a lot of great desire for what we wanted in a new home. Lori, she says, well, you keep talking about these great ideas and dreams, but where is the money going to come from? She's being realistic. But we keep building up the dream and not changing it. We're still in the house. And now it's getting to the point where I got to either put a new roof on this house soon or bulldoze it or get out from under it. So how would you suggest we go about realizing the dream that we've been working on for 14 years?
Well, after listening to you for a little while, we were very happy to hear you wrap it up with that statement. How can we go about realizing the dream? And what you have demonstrated here in really a very helpful way for everyone who may ever listen into this is you are seeing your creation of your home as something that requires decisions regarding action. In other words, you're talking about staying or going, which is action. You're talking about putting a roof on or not. You're talking about applying money to it, which is action. You're talking about finding a new place. In other words, almost all of the options that arose out of this conversation that you just offered sound like, what do we do about this? Should we do this or should we do that? And what we want to call your attention to is to the very end that you came to when you said, how can we realize our dream? We want you to realize that through all of this living of life, through all of these 14 years, and even before you got into that house, you've been through the trial and error of life, so to speak. There is no error, but the weighing the pros and the cons and the pluses and the minuses, you have created a dream. You have created, the two of you, you've done it individually, but you have collectively created a wonderful new living situation that your attention to the action part of your life is depriving you from moving toward. In other words, the way we see it, and it is so clear and so accurate, is that as we stand back and have watched you, you have, through living in this house and through taking the tours of the other houses and through being with friends and through watching television and through raising your children, you have launched and you have created this vibrational escrow of your dream house. And it is a remarkable thing to see. It would please you so much if you were in it today. So from our farther view, we see this culmination that is vibration, that manifestation is just a short way away. Once something has amassed in vibrational escrow, the physical coming together of it is a very simple process once it has been created here. But virtually every word you spoke here, as you've been talking to us, had you pointed in opposition to this thing that you've created. In other words, as you're pointing out what's wrong with this house and how you can't really afford what you think you want anyway, everything that you were feeling and therefore everything that you were doing vibrationally was in opposition to this house that is pulsing and breathing and waiting for you. So when your mate says to you, where are we going to get the money? As you beat that drum of that, you push in opposition, and that's why those kinds of comments feel so uncomfortable. But it would feel equally uncomfortable to say, okay, we're going to try to sell this, and hopefully between the two we'll come out pretty good, and we'll figure out somehow how to get enough money to make up the difference. That's upstream too. So you say, all right, Abraham, you give me no choice. You say, don't do that and don't do that. And we say, what we're really saying is don't do anything, because nothing is about action right now. What you want to do is tend to your dream. What you want to do is let the dream that you have created and the dream that is alive and well, what you want to do is find a way to come into vibrational alignment with it. So you've got to do something different than you've been doing. And what we're talking about all day, every day in these workshops is the only thing that you have to do is to stop thinking the thoughts and saying the words that keep your boat from turning, which will take you toward your dream house. So what you say to each other are things like, well, there's no decision for us to make right now. We don't need to take any action right now. And that might give you a sort of feeling of relief. You might say, this roof will make it through another year or two. We don't have to make that decision right now, this red hot minute. We've been doing all right. We've got our basement secured enough that the water is not really flowing in. I was just beating that drum in order to justify how much I wanted the new house. And that's the thing that we really want you to understand. By making peace with the house that you have, you will stop beating the drum that takes you upstream. But people say, Abraham, if I make peace with the house I have, isn't that like saying to the universe, I'm satisfied with where I am? And we say, it might be if your vibrational escrow wasn't full of another house. In other words, there's no confusion about what you've created. And when you stop bad-mouthing where you're at, you stop going upstream. So stop talking negatively about the house you've got. You're messing it up for future buyers anyway. You're sending out a broadcast that says, come and buy this crummy house from me.
Yes.
But as you start basking in the cleverness of you, as you acknowledge what a good property this has been, as you acknowledge how perfect it has been for you and how it is larger than most, and how the landscaping has matured and how it sits in the midst of a wonderful environment, and how so many people would be so happy to move right into it as is, and how satisfied you are to be there for now while what you are really moving toward is framing up for you. You feel relief, 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 relief in all of that thought. So you say things like, oh, isn't it nice that we live in this great house? And won't it be nice to watch how the universe delivers to us the people who are exactly ready for this house in the same way that we were when we got there? And won't it be nice when it all comes together? And I really believe that it will unfold just perfectly, that things that we can't see now will come into alignment. Jerry said just this morning, as he was talking about this wonderful property that they have back in Texas that is about 40 acres now, but they purchased the first two pieces, which was 3 acres and 2 acres, from the same person. And then the next adjoining piece just was offered to them, and then the next adjoining piece, and then another 20-acre adjoining piece. It just unfolded as if their dream was alive and well in vibrational escrow, and when they got their negative attention off what wasn't working, the universe said, look over here, look over here, look over here, look over here, look over here.
The biggest issue is, I think it's more of this, you know, Lori needs to make that leap of faith that it'll work out. She, you know, what I've you know, told her in the past is, don't worry about the financial side of it. It's going to work out. And she says things like, well, when I talk to these builders, they want to know how much money you have to spend. And, you know, she gets all hung up on that aspect of it. And I said, well, tell them not to worry about that, you know, or find another builder that isn't asking us that. So that's kind of where we're at, I think.
What we want you to hear from us is that your cause is secure and that your house is real and that it is in the process of becoming and that it will be yours in very short order, provided you can turn this way in the stream more times than you turn that way. We're not saying you have to be this way all the time. We're just saying you got to talk your resistance down. So the audience laughed when you said that Lori has some hang-ups because they didn't listen to Lori's rampage of resistance from this chair. They heard yours. And you each have resistance for different reasons, you see.
Yeah. She didn't want to come up here, though, so I'm kind of speaking a little bit for her. So...
all of that's true, but here's the way that Source Energy is looking at this. Your new house is a done deal.
Yeah.
If you will turn toward it, it will be yours fast. But as long as you're playing this, it won't work for this reason and this reason or
right.
this reason, or even, Abraham, this is how it is, this is how it is now, 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 how
right.
it is now. This is how it is now. This is how it is now. And this is how Lori thinks it is now. And this is how I think it is now. But this is how it is now. This is how it is now. Did I tell you that this is how it is now? This is how it is now. And what we want to hear from you is, this is how it is now, but this is temporary. And
sure.
what we've created is real over here, and we're just trying to figure out how we can get over there. And Abraham, are you telling us that we don't have to figure out how to get over there, we just have to stop going this way?
Okay.
And we're saying it is an emotional journey. It's not about action. It's not about action. Someone called Jerry the other day and told him that they were putting a check in the mail for, neither one of them want us to tell you how much, huge amount of money. Esther laughed uncontrollably because money is coming from everywhere in such large abundance, it makes them laugh hysterically. It is illogical by all standards. Their property values, they have gone up by 10 times. They spent lifetimes amassing this vibrational escrow, and it doesn't feel like they've done nearly enough to deserve the reaping of all of this reward. Really, all they're doing is a little bit of this. Just a little bit of this. And they're not even that good at it. They're just doing more of this than they are that. That's all. And on some subjects, it's so easy to go with the flow, and some subjects not so hard. But they're doing so much more of this now than they are with this, that things that have been lined up outside their door for years are coming into their experience. And Esther, she could not stop laughing. Jerry said, "Why is this so funny to you?" And Esther said, "Because it's sort of like I'm finally getting it, how simple it is. It was never about action. It wasn't about finding another house. It wasn't about finagling some sort of financing. It wasn't about any of those action things. It was only about thinking thoughts that align with my dream rather than opposing it. That was all it was about. And source energy, universal forces, fairies of the universe, circumstances and events take care of everything else. I no longer have to justify the well-being that flows to me because, frankly, it'll get flowing so good, you can't justify it." Esther said, "How are we going to explain that to anybody?" First thing she said to Jerry is, "Don't tell anyone. Don't tell anyone. No one will get it. No one would think that we would deserve that for that. Don't tell them." And what she's meaning is, she can hardly believe it. Oh, she believes it more than she doesn't believe it, or it wouldn't be happening. But she realized that there's this big disconnect between the abundance that flows to me and my deservability of it. And you and almost everybody else, you know, Lori too, you've been trying to justify this house by finagling, by hard work, by financial management, by being able to afford it. You're trying to justify it through action, and you just can't. Justify it through your positive expectation and watch the universe deliver to you not only all of the treasures that you seek, but the means to afford them." Yes.
Thank you. That was excellent. I think Lori got a lot out of that, too.